following program may not be suitable for younger listeners. This show does not reflect the views of this channel or its affiliates. Please stand by.
The Sky JR is on my TV! I took my pills! I didn't get any money! What's this guy Dobbs trying to do to me? I gotta get a gun or a job. I gotta get a gun or a job. I'm sick of Bob.
To run away from anything, because I don't believe in anything. What direction's the zoo in?
Back the other way. That where you escaped from?
But let's leave things of this world behind and walk now down the path of Bob for this brief minute of slack from the Church of the Subgenius.
The devil owes you money, friend. But Bob Dobbs is the bank where you can cash it in. We gotta burn out the banks of the devil. We gotta root him out. Burn out the hate. Burn out the radiation. Burn out the fire.
Standing around acting like you got wires of blood and anybody else, but you ain't, because I'm the one that has it, not you, me.
What are you talking about?
About I know things I ain't never learned. How I can see signs. It's something that just happens, and I got to do some things sometimes. I got to do some things sometimes I don't even want to do. And sometimes inside me, I can feel it. I can feel it pulling and tugging at me and pushing, and I can feel my blood beating, and I got to do this thing right now. It's wise blood. Ain't everybody has it. See, it's a gift. It's a gift, like a gift of the prophets. Now, I ain't saying I'm a prophet. No, it ain't like that, but it's like that.
You're crazy, boy. You get away from me and you stay away. I'm going where I'm going. I got a woman. I got a woman, see? And that's where I'm going, to visit her.
He thinks if he keeps on insulting you that you'll go away.
Whoa. Scary and neat.
Oh, no. More callers going in and out of little caller doors. We can do those clicks, too. Oh, there he is. Quick, fire one. Oh, he missed it. There he is. Quick, fire another one.
Hey, are you fed up with boring radio?
Tired of Turgid and Tedious Top 40?
Prepare to puke of a pretty paw.
The Subgenius Hour of Slack.
Welcome, potential initiates, and remain with us for the next 30 minutes.
Driven to suicide with the pressures of a crumbling society? Fed up with hip lightweights? Well, get ready to kick back and explore the psychodynamics of abnormality. Because the doctors are here. Yes, don't worry. Everything's all right. Everything's just fine.
Yes, dear friends, everything's just fine. This is Reverend Ivan Stang, and it's so good to be back in Dallas after another sojourn afar in search of historic Bob. This time it was New York City, and yes, friends, I left that package of Subgenius video PR at MTV, just like they asked me, and I haven't heard a peep out of them since. And that's good for MTV not to call us back after finding out what we were really about, I think says something in our favor. praise that old Bobby. We did have better luck at Spin Magazine, a Screw Magazine, and Simon & Schuster, who will now be Praise Bob officially reprinting the book of the Subgenius this spring. Praise Dobbs, and you'll all have to buy new copies now because the second edition will be a little different from the first. So things are looking up for the mighty Church of the Subgenius, friends. Now, last week, you listeners were sadly banished from the glowing, benevolent rays of the lofty, intellectually highfalutin, urethodox, Stangian paradise type of show to the bitter hell of the buck-naked doctrinal schism. Now, friend, you're going to have to decide. Are you a Stangite, a nakedite, or just a U-ite, eh? You're going to have to pick a side. Well, friends, I want you to know that I could be out hunting me some prairie squid tonight. I could. But I mean, I don't have to do this show. Most of y'all don't even deserve the sweet word of Bob. But this is going to be an easy one, though, because tonight we offer you a sampling of other Subgenius radio ministries in other states and even other lands. The airwaves tonight, friends, will be fraught with peril as shows collide around you for the next hour. Because last week we got tapes from the Serious Abuse Show. These are weekly Subgenius programs for friends. The Subgenius Serious Abuse Show from Richmond, Virginia, which is a brand new one and mighty fired up with the pure hate, the gospel hate of Dobbs, friends. And from the brand new Hour of Slack in Boston, Massachusetts, with Bleepo Abernethy, from the Sister Chris Subgenius Half Hour at WFMU in New Jersey. And last but first, the More Than an Hour, Less Than a show from KPFA Berkeley. And you'll see how lucky you heathens are to have the Dallas Hour of Slack right here in the very cradle of the Bob. Because these foreign shows, some of them are a little bit better at sacred, the sacred church occultation technique known as listener elimination. Of course, Buck and I have been known to show the occasional total disregard for the listener's feelings, but we don't hurt you randomly, dear friends. We aren't doing this. We aren't tormenting you just to amuse ourselves. Nay, we hurt you for a reason, a good reason. And that reason is our great thrice-killed guru, J.R. Bob Dobbs. This show and all other Subgenius shows are designed to have a calculated effect on the bicameral split between your left and right brains, and that's why you have to listen in stereo. Otherwise, you won't be able to get the strands separated, and you'll get all tangled up in the dogma that we broadcast at you. Now, all of we radio doctors are accredited surgeons of the airwaves, bred to make media in the festering cauldrons of childhood sci-fi shows. Children of the media age, my friends, so mutated that the media itself becomes for us far more important than those who watch or listen to it. This show is not a privilege of ours. We do not consider ourselves obliged to help you or even to entertain you, dear friend, because of the existence of J.R. Bob Dobbs, it's the other way around. It's mandatory that you listen to us, and you're mighty lucky you're allowed to, dear friends. Now, that understood, we may now proceed with the tape recording.
All the callers are lining up right now to talk to the doctor.
The doctors!
But don't worry. Everything's all right. Your radio is taking control of you. Relax. You're in the hands of the doctors.
The motion picture you're about to see contains scenes so terrifying, the public must be given grave warning. Therefore, the management has instituted visual and audible warning at the beginning of each of the four supreme fright points. The fear flasher is the visual warning. The horror horn close your eyes when you hear the horror horn.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut
up! What must the listeners at home think? It's terrible in the cavernous, echoey shell of our rocket with all these floating babies and the zero gravity, the dogs pinwheeling by, and we're having a little bit of navigational difficulties, but we're still transmitting to you the Subgenius hour and a half of true cosmic puzzlingness and evidential nausea and the will to disbelieve. Knowledge comes, but wisdom lingers, and it bears a laden crest, full of sad experience, moving toward the stillness of your rest.
Physical discomfort or loneliness, the cure is obvious.
I always wanted to be on the radio. Now I have a chance, and better than Christmas.
He's boring, megalomaniacal, monotonous.
A movie camera, table tennis, a wallet, a dog.
What? I hear the magic word, boing me!
Yeah, that's closer, that's closer, that's closer. You can achieve it. You will achieve the sighter spasm with the Exus if you do that enough, friend.
This caller has just requested that I perform a wedding for him this coming weekend.
It's the first wedding over the phone now. We can historically
can perform
at WMBR,
this,
at least.
Wedding over the phone.
We can perform this wedding over the phone
right now,
if you would like.
Right now.
Yes, okay, Rachel and Stefan, you know the seriousness of the commitment you're bringing yourself to, and you realize that all the consummations that make up a relationship between a man and a woman that you've already done before. Well, where you're at now is you're going to make the deal that binds it all together. So, do you, Rachel, take Stefan to be your lawfully wedded husband, with the word of Bob to be your guiding light?
Yes, so help me, Bob.
And you, Stefan, take Rachel to be your lawfully wedded wife with Bob's true slack. True slack being your guiding force in your lives.
Help me, Bob.
Okay,
I can't take this, Dr. Fishmonger. It's too beautiful.
I want you to join hands. I want you to shake hands. I want you two to shake hands.
Yes.
And say, it's a deal.
It's a deal.
Praise Bob.
Praise Bob. Yeah. Oh, praise Bob. That was a beautiful thing.
Beautiful thing. And may they have a wonderful life together.
The first legal marriage over the airways of WMBR.
That's right. The
Cambridge.
Reverends of the Church of the Subgenius are legally empowered to perform marriages. So
we do invite your calls here at 49.
Can you see?
Jesus calls you. Jesus calls you.
Hey, looky down yonder. You see that blind man down there? He's giving out tracts and begging Jesus. You ought to see him. And he's got this here ugly child. I mean, you better get on the other side, lady. There's a fool down there giving out tracts.
Don't pay no attention to that fanatic up there.
Don't I know what exists and what don't? Ain't I got eyes in my head? Am I a blind man? Let me tell you something. Maybe you think that you ain't clean because you don't believe. Every one of you are clean. And I'll tell you why. If you think it's because of Jesus Christ crucified, you're wrong. I ain't saying he wasn't crucified, but I say it wasn't for you. I'm gonna start a new church, the Church of Truth, without Jesus Christ crucified. And it won't cost you nothing to join my church.
It
ain't started yet, but it's gonna be. I don't need Jesus. What do I need Jesus for? I got Leora Watt.
Preachers, they must there be seen.
Attention, rich.
Upset.
This is the voice of the Red Cave Media Center, loosely affiliated with the Church of the Subgenius. Broadcasting to you from the studios of EFN.
doctor is in.
Yes, the not doctors are in.
Just straight talk.
Just some straight
Dr.
BS.
Dr. Gene Scott.
From your hosts, Dr. Can't Sleep, Dr. S.B. Boyd, and Dr. T.M. Oscar. Tired of the conspiracy telling you what to do, Just listen to the doctors, or even call 289-UR90.
No, don't call that number. Don't call any number.
God don't like it too. And Bob don't like it neither. And now, the doctors.
Yes, dear friends. And what we just heard was a sampling of... you got a little bit of your Berkeley show with Puzzling Evidence, Dr. Al, and a show that Dare Not Speak Its Name, and Gary Brokefran. And you got your Rat Cave media show with Steve Slack and T.M. Oscar doing that from some horrible little college station. They're a hateful bunch of ranters there. A bit of the Hour of Slack Boston, Massachusetts version. Now, of course, the Berkeley was the first weekly Subgenius radio show. But, friends, you know, the Subgenius shows thus far, they tend to fall into two groups. Either the well-manized, willy-nilly, happening, be-in, call-in, love-in kind of show, a la that Berkeley show, or the Rat Cave, Virginia show. Versus your Stangian or Abernathian, Bostonian show-type shows, which are the tightly scripted and heavily edited and censored pieces of Bob packaging, which you have come to so know and love, baby. And let's just see. And this here on camera 3 is... a WFMU in New Jersey. This will be the fifth one we're playing. This is Sister Chris. Or this is actually a guest of the mighty Sister Chris who came in from Poland, I believe.
Now, see another dimension on your TV.
Wait a minute. I don't want to see any more dimensions on my TV. Shoot, we ran the videotape instead. I'm sorry. Those little Super 8 video cassettes confuse me with this audio.
Bob's promise is to widen the scope and nature of abnormal behavior, to explore new ways of going over the edge.
Yes, indeedy. This is Sister Grażyna, back on the airwaves of WFMU. Sister Chris and I have reconciled our differences about muscling in on airtime and spontaneous feelings, etc. And I'm here to tell you, out there in the ether, about my experiences with UFOs and my religious convictions. And I don't mean arrest records, you understand? I'm rambling about the spiritual, the metaphorical, and the comically cosmic. And my first visitation happened when I was 4 years old. One overcast and communist-oppressed day, I was playing in the family beet field with my hometown of Wyborowa, when this strange buzzing sound was boring what felt like big hole in my skull, and a stiffening inaction took over my whole body and my toes too. And then it seemed as if the sound tried to pull me out, my living soul, out my body shell, but there was too much resistance. Too bad no one was around to witness this extraterritorial shenanigans there. It must have looked pretty weird from the outside. On the inside, I was confused and terrified. I was literally excreting building material. But the crazy kid I was, it started to feel nice. Like new kind of amusement ride. I don't remember much else about that first experience or how long it lasted. The thing is, ever since that time, I've been hearing strange voices and been on the receiving end of many bizarre visions. Psychiatrists and other members of the craziness oppression cast call me and the others of the chosen sect insane. But I know, I am positively sure that I communicate regularly with the angels, the messengers of Jehovah One, who travel like the wind and turn not as they go. And Bob say, yes, I know, I talk to Bob too. Bob say, it's all right to rock out and jam with these aliens as long as I get the minimum daily requirement of slack that I need. And as long as they don't rip my lungs out my chest if I do something, you know, that they don't like.
Years will bring more wondrous and miraculous change and carnage, insanity, and destruction than all of mankind's history and prehistory before.
Well, we've heard all of that. Dear friends, I just had a caller calling up wanting to know what the deal was on the afterlife, if there was one, and what they were going to do to him when he got there. And I explained to him that we've got five stages that we know of, starting with the bottom. The Christian hell. We talked about this about three shows back. You got your Christian hell on the bottom, then your Christian heaven, then your earth, which is, of course, another layer of hell. Then you got higher than that, though, a lot more comfortable, is the Subgenius hell, which wouldn't really be punishment. But really, believe me, you believe me, don't you? This is eternal salvation or triple your money back. We wouldn't try to lead you down the wrong path. Yes, the Subgenius heaven is even above the Subgenius hell, and that's Asgard, known in other tongues, or, you know, Nirvana. Actually, it makes Nirvana seem like getting your eyes carved out with a pair of pliers, and just one end of the pair of pliers, not yanked out, but gouged out. That's what Nirvana is like compared to the mighty squirting universe of the Subgenius heaven. Don't that bless your heart, friends? Well, this is the Subgenius Hour of Slack radio ministry with the Church of the Subgenius here at KNON 90.9 FM in Dallas, Texas, and environs, and we're playing excerpts from sister and brother shows all over the place. What you just heard was an excerpt from the Sister Chris show. She gets tapes from one of the lovely nun snakes in Poland, in communist Poland, and I've been getting tapes from the Pope of all China, Comrade Communist China. This is Dr. Li Jing in Beijing, and you can't write to him because that would get him in a whole lot of trouble, dear friends. But he's going to be sending some more updates of his Chinese 3 minutes of slack in Chinese. By the way, speaking of Chinese, I saw a great movie last night, A Great Wall. Can't tell you where because that would be an advertisement which you didn't pay for. But anyway, here we go.
Chris Bob. Oh yes, dear friends. This is Li Lijing, the Chinese Subgenius. And you are listening to the Hour of Slack on KNON in Dallas, Texas. Remember, Bob is the comrade of all people. Here in China, just like in America, the people need slack. In Chinese, we call slack Le Tian Pai. But it must be true slack, not the best slack of the conspiracy. Chris Bob, help me somebody.
We said wake up!
This is Dr. Can't Sleep, and you can't sleep tonight.
No sleep in Richmond tonight because the doctors have taken control of WDCE-FM. As forewarned, oh, you were fooled by the dates on the flyers. You yes. thought it was tomorrow night.
We're always ahead of time.
Yes, we have time control. And we'll be telling you how you too can exercise time control later tonight on tonight's show.
This is Dr. S.B. Void, ready to shave off the top of your head at a moment's notice.
I guess we should be grateful for the media manipulators who have allowed us to be on.
What, Bob? What did you say? I'm sorry, Bob was just talking to me there.
Is Bob there in the background squeaking among those trays of white mice?
Yes, Bob might show up tonight if we get enough callers. At what's the number there, Dr. Roy?
That's 28. Yes, call us up in our official Subgenius all-night radiothon for mental dystrophy, a frightening disease which is crippling most of the minds here in the Commonwealth.
Call up and... Well, you know...
Yes, you have reached the show. How about that?
That was certainly unintelligible. Well, yes, thank you for that holy pronouncement there. Holy,
I'm enlightened.
Thank you for that holy distribution.
I see the light. I understand now. I understand it all.
We can just pack up the show and go home. We've answered all the questions in just 10 minutes.
That's
thanks
right.
to that
caller.
One phone call. All it takes is one call and all your problems are over.
Yes, I believe that was the theme for this current show, the corpulence of a crumbling society.
So
this is the boring part of this show.
Oh, it's getting so boring.
This is the part where you go out for coffee and donuts.
Oh, let's just go out and watch a hardcore show and get drunk and go home and pass out.
See,
we're
stalling. We're actually stalling. We're saving the better part of this
yes.
show until
you'll
2:30
have to stay up till 5 a.m.
home.
To hear the good part of this show.
And the sounds of the stress and strain of
what was. Tuned in, we're in the final countdown of what is hoped will be mankind's first orbit around the moon.
I was wondering, has the show started yet?
No.
This is the warm-up. We generally warm up.
Pre-show warm-up?
Yes.
We're broadcasting from outer space to radio station KPFA. And a garbled version is reaching you. Oh, I'll get it. Oh, why, come in. Welcome to our show.
Hi, Mom.
Rogers, we're going. Whichever you'd like to refer to this.
Set recorders for stun.
And as the message is broadcast back to the Earth, Mobius Rex turns it into code which only the high masters, the elders, can understand when they listen to this show. We're passing through clouds of images and words which were sent from Earth many years ago. Fortunately, we catch up with them, and then we pass them. But our linguistic scoop brings them to you for your listening pleasure. The amazing tales from the Church of the Subgenius. Be there for the end of the private life and the destruction of the American dream. Don't say you weren't warned.
I've got to save you.
Do it again.
That's the idea.
You are normal, aren't you?
And that's a little bit.
Stay away. Keep your distance.
You are normal, aren't you? I mean, you are normal, aren't you? Oh, yes, dear friends. Well, I'll tell you what. That last one was the Berkeley show. Just so you keep track, that was the show with the one guy with the really heavy eyebrow right across the middle. That's unibrow. And then there was the heavier guy with the glasses and the incredible vocabulary, and that's Dr. Howell. And then there was the Rastafarian with real pale face and really tanned fingers and palms. And that was Gary Gabrogefriend. Well, friends... I have to pause here in the midst of this wonderful barrage of tapes and explain to you why you can't call in. Now, 2 weeks ago, dear friends, many of you faithful who listen to every hour of Slack, because you need every hour of Slack in your week, many of you heard the sermon about our friend the prairie squid, that frisky and fecund mollusk so dear to the hearts of all us country boys and girls. But Dr. G. Gordon Gordon and I got so carried away with ranting about the forbidden delights of that pesky land squid that we completely neglected the warnings, the stern warnings, friends, that should be delivered to all squid fornication novices, i.e., we forgot to mention the arboreal squids, which... dear friends, secrete a poisonous fluid from their inner sheath We forgot to mention the night squids, which carry foul diseases, and the toothed squids, which are rather hard to dislodge from your body once you start to, do what you do with a prairie squid. I don't think I have to spell that out. But worst of all, friends, and I can only beg your forgiveness for this, if this warning comes too late, we forgot to tell you about the beak of the prairie squid. They all have that beak, friends, even though you can't see it. And you have to pull the beak with a pair of pliers before you start to, before you make them safe to use. And Dr. Gordon and I sort of took it for granted that was common knowledge, that everybody knew to de-beak a squid before you get on with your business. And as much as we make fun of people who don't know what a prairie squid is, we don't want the responsibility for a bunch of city boys getting out there and they don't know jack about a squid, friends, and they don't have to, a pink boy don't have time for foreplay with a prairie squid. Oh, it's just an animal. What do I have to worry about? These pink boys, they don't want to mess with tickling that squid to get it to quiet down a bit, calm it down. Oh, they're afraid to pull the beak because, it might hurt the poor beast. And we'll be getting all these calls on our answer machine at the Bulldog of Time Control headquarters from boys with high voices saying, "Oh, Reverend Stan, I should have sent for instructions from Bob, but I blew it off. Oh, Bob, why didn't I send you money?" Oh, they'll be wailing and holding their stitches, friends. Oh, those of ye who were too dumb to know what a prairie squid is to begin with, you'll be finding out the once hard way, so to speak. So beware the prairie squid, my son. Beware that beak that bites. They don't know jack about a squid, friends, and they don't have to, a pink boy don't have time for foreplay with a prairie squid. Oh, it's just an animal. What do I have to worry about? These pink boys, they don't want to mess with tickling that squid to get it to quiet down a bit, calm it down. Oh, they're afraid to pull the beak because, it might hurt the poor beast. And we'll be getting all these calls on our answer machine at the Bulldog of Time Control headquarters from boys with high voices saying, "Oh, Reverend Stan, I should have sent for instructions from Bob, but I blew it off. Oh, Bob, why didn't I send you money?" Oh, they'll be wailing and holding their stitches, friends. Oh, those of ye who were too dumb to know what a prairie squid is to begin with, you'll be finding out the once hard way, so to speak. So beware the prairie squid, my son. Beware that beak that bites. And the girls don't have to worry about that because the part of a prairie squid that a girl uses doesn't have a beak. Although in the South American variety, they sport little spines up and down. And of course, those are treasured by some sophisticated ladies of society. And friends, now as you know, we have recorded some 41 Hour of Slack shows. This one is number 40, no, 42. But 2 weeks ago, friends, someone else screwed up royally, and the Mighty Prairie Squid show was not recorded in its entirety. We're missing a good tape of the first half hour of one of our shows. So to those beloved diehards out there who tape this show, and I know there's some out there, please, dear friends, for the love of Bob, send us your tape of the Prairie Squid Show. Send us a copy if you must. Send the original, and we'll make it worth your while. You'll get a free extra copy of all Subgenius books and publications, plus several uncut media barrage audio tapes as well, and a chance to be in Bob's new music video. So why don't you just send that tape to P.O. Box. This is Bob. This is the number where you can write for information about prairie squids, prairie squid safety, about where to get the slack that the conspiracy denied you, about where to find Bob and put him in your life and get back the juices that were stolen in the night by those evil succubi and things of the darkness. And friends, that you got that pencil now? The number to write is Bob. That's the number. at P.O. Box 140306, Dallas, Texas 75214. That's right, friends. Send that tape of the Prairie Squid Show and send us your return address. Send us anything. We will pay you back in ways you can't imagine. The Church of the Subgenius can pay you back for that tape of this mighty show that we so need, because it was such a nasty one, you know, without using any bad words. So I'll praise Bob so they won't be having a Senate committee investigate us this year. Well, friends, this is KNON 90.9 in Dallas, Texas. 90.9 FM. Yeah! There's mighty Li Jing, the agent for Bob in China. He's about to close in on those conspiracy bad guys who stole that bucket of slack and that beautiful girl. Hope Li Jing. He's a bad, bad spy for Bob in Red China. And he's closing in on the conspiracy.
That one looks pretty good. Now what? Well, sir, I'm telling you. In fact, I'm going to come right out and say it. Nobody listens to this show. Bob came out of that book.
Bob came out of that fire squad.
Yes, it was. Future.
Bob came out of the phone book.
Or who knows?
Bob came from the phone company.
Another chapter.
The phone company created Bob. It was the phone company. This is the truth. This is the truth. Nothing else on this show is true but this.
It is the moment we all been waiting for.
I know, I'll be taken out and
shot. Tell us which phone company.
At that time, there was only one phone company. At the time I speak of, there was only one phone company covering the earth. Its tendrils extended in any direction.
Listen, you shouldn't be wasting your time with this stuff.
And so it was that Ivan Stang came upon the sacred tower of the phone book, which he found in the men's room of the bus station. And in that phone book was the face that we know as a mass of dots. A mass of aligned dots, a strange, convoluted grouping of energy which may have traveled through space and time for longer than anyone knows. But it came out of the phone book. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I know they want to silence me because they don't want this to get through. But he came from the phone book.
I think there's something wrong with your tape.
It's 1984.
What I like about the Church of the Subgenius is that you can totally screw up and then become Pope and collect an enormous amount of money and gain eternal salvation, or at least a nice piece of beachfront property.
That's right.
Bob is just a wonderful thing, whatever he is.
He doesn't forgive your sins. He doesn't care about your sins. He justifies your sins. He
you shows can hate him. You can kill him. You can love him. It doesn't matter. He's just kind of like a pop-up and down toy. I just love it, and I like the Southwest that will probably kind of sneak over and eat the East and the West. It's kind of a bi-location deal.
Oh, my. What's happening? Oh no,
I think you've been duplicated, Dr. Gordon.
Oh no, what's happening? Oh no, what's happening?
I can't tell.
Oh no,
can you?
What's happening?
I can't believe this is happening to me.
What's happening?
I keep crawling into those black holes. They're so enticing.
What's happening to me?
You've been duplicated. Well, hey,
we have another caller here at the Subgenius Asylum Anti-Pinkness. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, yes, this is Reverend Bleepo Abernathy. How may we serve you?
Hello, Reverend, and I'd like to address a question to Dr. Albert Fishmonger.
Fishmonger here.
Yes, doctor, I was wondering, the caller mentioned earlier the question of whether one has to be into water sports to hate Bob, and you had explained it as the elements which you use for your hatred weren't important. I think that the listeners should also know, though, that although other elements can be used, I think that bodily fluids are the most vital and
It is indeed a holy rite, and we talk about it frequently, to pee on Bob's head. And when I talk about the elements of fire and water.
You can pee on Bob's head, friend, and R and S and T U V, of course.
All of those.
And any of those things.
But like, it is. It's also important to note that, like,
we're just talking about the letter P, of course.
When we talk about, like, you know, using the elements, I mean, when we talk about using the elements to honor Bob with, I mean, so that represents that fluid represents the water element, and like, and we use the air element when we breathe the sacred church air, and we use the fire element when we fire up the sacred frop stick, and yea, even upon Bob's head we can deposit earth in the form of the sacred night soil.
Well, what if drinking liquid slack until one has to return?
Well, you know, liquid slack can come in any one of a number of forms, friend. It can be Jack Daniels, it can be Pepsi Cola. Liquid slack
in my case right now, it's Canada Dry
ginger ale.
Free plug.
No, we can't do that. It's non-commercial radio. We have to give a plug to everything. Every other soda in the world now.
Oh,
Dr. Fishmonger,
Pepper.
What have you done?
Oh, classic.
Oh, Lord. We have to have equal time. Oh, no.
Human is slowly losing its meaning under a vast tidal wave of inhumane behavior. It's a tug of war between the fiercely retroactive steel trap mouth boot boys on the right and the equally insidious artsy snotty ass psychopathically hip squids on the left. The conspiracy has twisted the words good sex around to mean everything that you don't get. That way, they can humiliate you into obedience, run your treadmill trip, and make you fill out a scorecard. They tell you you have to have career goals, which is twisted to mean absolute obedience to whatever rut you happen to fall into. They can make you ugly and fat and bored, and then they want you to go home and beat off the solid gold.
Discuss this with the foreign minister and the president.
What about
the fact
Bob?
Is, they said, we are
they
moving
never
toward an
abolitionist
never consulted.
But what they also said, and what
God
the black leaders out in the ranks said, is this.
We'll be taking opinions
he
on this
has
way.
Made observations which, about the situation in South Africa, which are inconsistent with the facts. I
yes,
don't know
289-UR-90 tell us
Mr.
everything
Tutu,
we don't want to hear.
Not. Mr. Tutu doesn't
no
presume to be a political leader.
They don't
presumes to be what Mr.
Like
Falwell
this.
Presumes to be.
It's
a man of God and therefore
this.
A spokesman for a point of view.
289-UR-90 is our
selecting
phone number.
A leader.
You have
a
leader.
I want to know. What has Reverend Stang got to do with this conspiracy? No, wait. You may say, Stang? Oh, he couldn't do nothing. He's in charge of this radio show. He's the one responsible for putting my words over the air and all that over there. But, friends, that's completely impossible. You say, yeah, well, what about, like, Johnson and the JFK assassination? You ever ask yourself that? Sure, you know, mourning for the world and all that. Now, let's be frank here, folks. Now, I'm not saying Lyndon Baines was a bad man, but Lyndon Baines was a powerful man. Lyndon Baines was a man who could withstand pain. Who's to know what kind of strange hypnosis he underwent with them hypno-demons back when he visited that flying saucer on that Air Force base in 57 with Eisenhower? Yeah, he was a senator that was there that day. He was supposedly standing there watching the whole damn thing. Well, if you ask me, those aliens just hypnotized him, took them both aboard the spaceship there, and of course, erased part of the mind and then put it back and then made them forget that they could ever remember it, which just, you know, makes the whole subconscious drive to do the insane thing even stronger. I love those aliens. You gotta love those aliens. Anyway, I mean, you gotta admire them, let's say. Maybe can't exactly embrace them with what we call love. You know, it's sort of... Well, I can't go into that right now. But anyway, At any rate, so what I'm just saying there is, you know, it's entirely possible. Now, please, I don't want any lawsuits or nothing. It's just a theory I'm proposing.
I'm a zombie, we're on the heat of destruction.
And a handful of sandals, the
the one for truth. Integration, union, and respect is the sacred name. This whole crazy world is just too frustrating. But you can do those things over and over and over again, my friend. I don't think you're on me, but destruction.
Cross the surface of the skin toward the nearest opening. How many openings does the body have? Whichever one it's closest to, the tattoo slowly enters the opening and disappears inside the body, and there, moving through the endothelium, it makes its way God knows where. One tattoo might get trapped in the musculature behind the knee.
Oops.
But the right knee, gentle massage would break it loose. But then a strange change takes place in the tattoo. And as it reappears through whatever opening, you can see that it's changed. It's been digested somehow from its two-dimensional purple-red reality into some otherworldly hologram.
Tattoo hologram.
And there it dances across the body of the tattoo subject.
Beautiful.
That'll be one thing I'd like to see done.
Oh, I hope we do it.
Or how about the musical that I've never gotten around to, called starring the Siamese twins, connected by the lips.
The lips?
All sorts of things we never do. Crumple. I was going to write a book called Crumple once. All the pages would be crumpled. You'd reach in, take out a crumple, read it. Crumple it up, put it back in, reach in, take out another. Short stories. With each page numbered. If you took them out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the odds against that are pretty great.
True.
You'd wind up with the actual true meaning that was meant by the author.
Oh.
But the difficulty there is to find someone who can crumple all those pages. What if it were a bestseller? Think of the problems we'd have then. Of course, there's one other thing that I wanted to do, and that is find a plastic surgeon who could change pets to look like their owners.
What about the other way around?
Yes, we should resolve to do all these inappropriate things.
But don't we?
Like the levitator that I knew, who was a marvelous levitator. Gave lessons in levitating.
Let's do it.
Tried to teach me, but I never could get off the ground that way. He wanted to be a singer, though. He wanted to sing in a nightclub, and he was a horrible monotone. Really couldn't carry a tune. He would sing "My Funny Valentine, Sweet," you know, it was awful. But he was good at levitating, and as the devout catalyst, I got him into this nightclub. The Happy Medium. It's marvelous. He didn't sing well, but he levitated beautifully and had this girl with sequins, and very large girl, showbiz type girl, with a hula hoop with sparkles on it. And she'd, as he levitated singing "My Funny Valentine," she'd run the hula hoop so you could see that there was no trick to it.
Nice touch.
You know? Let's get together.
We are together.
In the pub.
And we're here.
Sometime. And write down all these things. You know, make a scenario. Then we'll go to Hollywood.
I've recorded the whole thing.
I don't know. Maybe they wouldn't think it was commercial enough.
Let's do it in Des Moines.
We can make the resolution anyway.
Okay, we'll do it in the double.
Yes, dear friends, we're together in the bub. That was Ken Nordine, a tape called Triple Talk, and some of y'all may have heard his stuff now and then. It's hard, you can only buy these from Ken Nordine. Or if you have an Hour of Slack show, why, they just appear in the mail. Praise Bob. And for immediate release, dear friends, they're having a musical theater conservatory auditions being held at MVC. That's right, Mountain View College Performing Artists Musical Theater Conservatory will be holding auditions at 7 o'clock p.m. on August 18th and 19th in the Performance Hall. Applicants will be required to perform 2 monologues, 2 music numbers, and must be prepared to dance. The following, the Performing Artists Musical Theater Conservatory is a one-of-a-kind intensive training program designed to develop professional-level performance skills in acting, singing, and dancing. Please call the Fine Arts Office at 333-8632 for an audition appointment and more information. Yes, dear friends. And this is Sister Chris speaking to the lost and the faithful alike, the damned and the blessed under Bob in New Jersey on another station.
Sister Chris, here with you to tell you that in the past weeks, I've delivered bits of rants such things as slack, time control, and other aspects of the Subgenius Church. The time has come for Sister Chris to relate to you my personal testimony to the salvation in slack that was released to/by me through the all-encrusting power of J.R. Bob Dobbs. Shameful though it may sound, there was a long period in my life when I had tripped and fallen off the luck plane of slack and knocked my head ad nauseum on the railing of the conspiracy stairway to doom. And the rut at the bottom of the stairwell was deeper than the valleys of Jane Mansfield. Food had no taste. My vision was constantly blurry, and television terrorized my time like a vampire, sucking my imagination dry. Life seemed drab and pointless, at best a droning irritation. I sought help in the blind alleys of nightclubs and other vices, but they only seemed to aggravate the situation. It was no fun. Then I literally stumbled onto a group of enlightened ones. Ones who were filled with the power and the glory of Bob. Words like slack, Bob, and WFMU in freeform hung in the air like sweet-smelling pipe tobacco. At last, the burning, irradiated light of slack began to sear my brain pan. I began to forget to be anxious among the pink boys and girls. I explored the remnants of my Subgenius heritage and ethics, and they were long forgotten during the amnesia of the zombie years. Now, I can't describe to you the step-by-step dismantling of all that conspiracy programming, because events didn't happen in a singular, linear fashion. The closest comparison would be to taking a shower in truth and slack under a pulsating nozzle. I still had problems and vices, but it was a lot more fun. My third eye had the clarity of the telescope at Mount Palomar. I relaxed in the safety of different illusions every day. The bottom line comes down to having fun. Yeah, Bob's human shell may be dead, and some people are depressed about that, some Subgenius and latent Subgeniuses. But his almighty power lives on through the gifted and the possessed. We just heard from this week's installment of the Church of the Subgenius tape. Heard every week here on WFMU.
No, that isn't WFMU. This is KNON 90.9 FM in Dallas, Texas. Well, this is the night of the vanishing co-hosts.
The vanishing people.
Yeah, right. No vanishing people, but all the mighty co-hosts. Oh, lo, how they hath fallen.
no sign of Buck naked, ain't hiding under anything, and Norm Ward has not walked through the door for Monday morning, but old mighty Johnny is here to do the anti-preaching.
Say what?
Well, we're gonna move down here. I don't even know what's on this one, friends. Oh, it hurts though. Oh, better turn your volumes down. And those of you who are trying to listen in mono, boy, friends, those shows are banging into each other over there on this left channel. Let me up.
Job of 14 and a half inch John Holmes Wang Dinger specials offensive if nobody's sleeving yours or you're not sleeving anybody's. You know, that's the whole problem. When you give something up, you expect everybody else to give it up too. And I think that's worse than if you take something up new, you should expect everybody else to. Because obviously, a lot of other people are already doing something because they want to, or think they want to, or they like to, or they like to think they want to, or they want to think they like to. Just because if they want to swear and smoke and drink, and in your opinion go to hell, that's their business. Not yours. The only business that's yours is yours, and if it's yours and it offends you, you better pull it out and look at it closely and find out why it offends you. Because I tell you, it offends you mostly because it reminds you that you're missing out on something. And that's why sometimes when we say things in the Church of the Subgenius, we offend people because it reminds them that they're in the grip of the conspiracy, because it reminds them they lead dreary, empty, stilted, hungry lives of desperation and quietness. They don't like the way we talk because it reminds them that they've got sexual organs, and if they would just make an effort, they could use them. They don't like the way we talk because we remind them that we're all animals and daily must fulfill our biological functions, and as they are something of which God Almighty or whoever brought us here gave us, we have no control over them. Therefore, they've been told, oh, that's nasty, put it in that little clean white bowl, that symbol of purity. Why do you have to flush away pure water with nothing but biological salts dissolved in it, with 5.5 gallons of fresh water that somebody could be cooking dinner and drinking? Ah, friends, it's because some people don't like to be reminded. They pretend that if they don't talk about it and don't think about it, then they can forget about it. And if they're not reminded that they have to squat down and like every other monkey on this planet every day, if things are working right, then maybe they think they aren't one of them monkeys that's on this planet. But the big, smart, dumb monkeys with too much shit, not enough time. Yeah, talking about you and all you other signifying monkeys. That's why people get offended. That's why they don't like to hear us talk about prairie squid. Oh God, how disgusting to use an aphorism of that disgusting nature. But what they're missing is the point that we're saying is that a prairie squid is just like any other wild animal. It's a natural thing. You can't cover up a prairie squid because it'll come creeping out some. And you stamp out the prairie squid and you stamp out life itself. That's what we're saying. We're saying that our biology is what we are and there's nothing we can do about it but enjoy it. That's why sometimes we offend people. That's why the church will never be something you'll see in primetime television. Because they don't want you to be reminded of what you really are. Because then you take a good look at yourself and realize that, hell, what am I doing all this them for? That's why they don't like for us to see these things. That's why prairie squid, poo dog, all those strange, strange cult references.
Ah, yes, dear friends, all those strange cult references. That's why it's all so important. And I'm sorry that didn't get out of here quite quick enough. But, dear friends, you can write for information from the Church of the Subgenius. And you'll get real information in the mail if you want to call it mail. It's Bob at P.O. Box 140-306, Dallas, Texas, 75214. Praise Bob. And tune in next week for one more breath of that church air, that mighty church air. And I've got to get out of here now. Thanks. Praise Bob.
It's another edition of Monday Morning on KNON 90.9 FM. I'm John Horton. Norm Ward is en route and will be joining us momentarily. A lot of things to talk about tonight at 828-9500. It's an open line, but we've got a few topics that we're going to be going over. By the way, how about those Dallas Cowboys, huh? 20-0. I don't even know if that was right. At least it wasn't 32-0 like happened today with the 49ers and the Raiders or something like that. I don't read the papers. What do you think I am, a knowledgeable kind of guy? Anyway, we're going to be talking about that, and I believe I hear Norm ringing downstairs, so if you'd go let him in, we'd all appreciate it. Some other things we have to talk about tonight, a special announcement for you. We'll be talking a little bit about something I saw on cable TV this week, which made me very sick. So a couple things we're going to talk about tonight. Who are your favorites in football this year? Who do you think is going to take it all?